Good morning, students. Today we will discuss how to measure the given angles with the help of protractor. Okay. For measuring angle, there are some points. For measuring angle, the degree is the unit of the angle. Okay. Like this, we are indicating. Suppose angle is 40, then degree is written like this. So unit of measuring angle is degree. Instrument by which we are measuring angle is the protractor. It is a semicircular shape like this. Okay. It is having two scales, inner scale and outer scale. You can see on my right side 0 to 180 means a scale which is starting from right side 0 and ending up to 180 on my left side. It is the inner scale, and you can see here on my left side, okay, on my left side 0 up to the 180 on my right side, it is the outer scale. So a protractor is consisting two scales, inner scale and outer scale. Each scale divided into 180 equal part means from 0 to 180, these are divided into 180 equal part means between 0 to 10 there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 means there are 10 equal parts. We can say very tiny or very small parts. Okay, so each scale is divided, means inner scale also as well as outer scale also, into 180 equal parts. Now look at it. When base arm of an angle coincide with zero of inner scale, means you can see this 90 is just in between, and it is a, if you will draw a straight line, then it will touch to the center. Okay, now you can see this line is the baseline, and center is just below the 90 degree angle. In the inner scale and outer scale, 90 degree is a common point where inner scale 90 as well as outer scale 90 is coming at the same place. Now, if this baseline, okay, and its center coincide with zero of inner scale, okay, with zero of inner scale, then we have to measure by using inner scale the given angle. Okay, and when the base r of an angle coincide with the zero of outer scale, then we have to use outer scale to measure. Now see the base r. Let me tell you, this is an angle, suppose this is an angle. Okay, now this particular r is the base r. Okay, now its common point means its point. Now this base r, if coincide with zero of inner scale, then for measuring we have to use the inner scale. And this base r coincide with the zero of outer scale, then we have to use to measure the outer scale. Okay. To this particular point, I will give you a simple method also. Let me tell you. Suppose this is the line. Okay, point A, B. Suppose you have to measure the angle from your right side point, then you have to keep this inner scale center at point B, and you have to use the inner scale. Okay, inner scale you have to use. And if the point on which you have to measure angle is on your left hand side, okay, then keep this center point at this and use the outer scale. Okay, so this is the particular way by which you can understand when we are using the inner scale and when we are using the outer scale. Okay, so you can draw, or in your book question number 13, a checkpoint, you can find out by using protractor the actual measurement of the following angles. Okay, so this is the particular common basic concept to which you have to remember while you are measuring a particular given angle. Okay, thank you.